Do you see that? That's the CAN bus, and I can see everything. I was wondering what to publish as my first gadget, and then it hit me. The first gadget I ever built became the foundation of all the others. So I thought, why not start with the one that started it all? And if you have no idea what I am talking about, you might want to pause and watch the earlier videos about my CAN project first. Now that you are up to speed, let's dive in. My very first gadget was a little bridge that helped me get all the CAN traffic from my car into SavvyCAN using a gateway I created from my CAN shield. SavvyCAN is a reverse engineering and capturing data tool for CAN, similar to Wireshark for network traffic. I use it to filter and analyze traffic and to confirm that I am seeing matching what I'm expecting from my projects. I also use it to automatically decode the traffic streams using DBC files so I can make sense of it all. The basic idea of this gadget, and most of my others, is to grab the data from the car's CAN bus and do something useful with it. With this particular SavvyCAN gadget, I aim to translate the CAN traffic coming from the car over ESPNow into a format that SavvyCAN could understand. Searching the web, I found a paper that explained how to set up sessions, send commands, and format CAN flow just right for the serial protocol that SavvyCAN understands. I translated that into code, and since I'm only interested in reading from the CAN bus, I skipped the parts about sending messages or adjust the CAN speed, because that was already set in the gateway itself. I loaded the code into a MrDIY Mini, which is an ESP8266 dev board. I won't fib. It took me a bit of time to fine-tune and troubleshoot the code, but once I did, I began to see the influx of traffic into SavvyCAN. I can now monitor the CAN IDs, data, length, flags, decoded values, and more. Just an easy flow of data from the car all the way to my monitor. There is one hitch though, the timestamp. It's always showing zero for now, but I think I can fix that. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I have been using PCBWay for years, and they are my go-to manufacturer for all my prototypes. I've been averaging a week from the time I place an order to the time I have them in my hands. I'm very happy with the quality so far, and ordering PCBs have come a long way, especially for hobbyists. So I encourage you to give them a visit. I will put a link to their site down below. Getting SavvyCAN up and running using the gadget is easy. I plugged in the gadget into the laptop's USB port, opened SavvyCAN, added a new device connection through the connections menu, chose serial, and picked the gadget USB port and the right serial speed, which matches what I set up in the code. The CAN speed setting doesn't matter really here, because it is configured in the gateway itself. With the settings shown, I have a new connection setup. The built-in DBC file manager is a very powerful tool. I can just add the file and all the traffic is decoded and displayed with this option. And once I have the CAN traffic coming in from the gateway, I can take full advantage of SavvyCAN to analyze it. It's worth noting that you have noticed the CAN traffic flows is one directional from the car to SavvyCAN. This means the gadget only reads CAN traffic and doesn't send any traffic back to the car's CAN gateway. Just wanted to mention that for clarity. Speaking of the gateway, I did some serious rework since my last update to make it better. First, I decided to remove the dependencies on the ESP32 CAN and CAN Common libraries and rewrote the CAN code using the two-wire automative interface functions directly in the expressive dev framework. I also fine-tuned and optimized the functions that are used the most. Thank you, ChatGPT. Also, instead of using the hard-coded ID for the ESPNow structure, I used the ESP32 MAC address to create a unique ID, which gets printed to the console on boot in case I want to use it for filtering purposes. Additionally, I added some code to help reduce the ESP32 heat, keeping the gateway cool, especially in summer days. Moreover, I beefed up the debug output and error logs too. Last but not least, I merged the two separate gateway codes I had, one for Tesla and one for OBD version, into one. So all the extra features in the OBD2 code, like the auto shutdown, are extended to Tesla as well. This merge will save me the hassle of redoing my work for both versions whenever I have a fix or update. If you want to give it a go, I made this flashing tool that lets you flash the firmware right from the browser with just one click. The Gateway and the SavvyCAN gadgets are both available for a quick flashing. From then on, I utilize this device as a handy tool to assist me in creating additional gadgets. That's what my next videos are going to be about. And as usual, links and resources are in the description. And that's a wrap for this gadget. Until next time, thank you for watching.